By the end of this video, you're gonna learn why anger isn't hot and how to use your anger more effectively. Hit subscribe, like, and the bell. I release new videos Wednesdays at 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Stay until the end to get a communications e-guide as a thank you for watching. I'm Amanda Pasciucco. I'm a licensed marriage and family therapist, and I specialize in helping people with difficult negative emotions. I'm gonna teach you what I taught hundreds of other clients about anger today. So let's just jump right in. People love to express anger. They often say it's helpful, that they should be able to express their emotions. Some people think that anger is important, that you have to let it all out. However, there is research that shows that when you let all your anger out, the cortisol levels spike, you can burn out your adrenals, it causes more stress on the heart and your blood pressure. So I would keep that in mind so that you understand that when you let your anger out, even though it might feel cathartic, it actually isn't the best for your overall health, according to some research. Also, when you let out a lot of angry emotions, sometimes you actually get more angry. I've had experiences with people who were coming session after session and letting out anger, and what I kept getting was more anger. It's like the reserves never stopped. I think it's important for anger to be appropriately stated, especially if you're in a moment of violence. You need your anger. However, to just think about it over and over makes you angrier. It doesn't actually make you happier or feel more positive emotions. Also, think back to a time where you were really angry. Are you proud of all the things that you've done? A lot of times you do things that aren't really what you would commonly do. When you're in a part of you that's angry, you lash out, you're disrespectful, and you appear to be emotionally hysterical instead of emotionally stable. Not that that is always negative, however, it's important to be mindful of the impact you have on others around you, especially if there isn't violence, but your anger is coming across emotionally violent to them. When we get angry, we stop thinking with our whole brains. The prefrontal cortex kind of like disconnects, and we're only dealing with the reptilian brain back here. Also, we start using words like always or never, and things like that are extreme and rarely true. Have you ever felt like you've used anger or seen someone use anger and felt they were less attractive? If so, please comment below. Why do people even like to get angry? Anger is exciting. It also causes adrenaline to run through the body, and some people like the feeling of that adrenaline and don't know how to create it other than with angry emotions. The angrier you get, also there's a chance that people are more likely to give you what you want. It doesn't mean that they're doing it out of like the kindness of their heart. They're doing it because they feel coerced or forced. That's not actual consent, but it's a form of just putting a bandage on it and moving forward. Again, the only time that getting angry, in my opinion, is appropriate is if there is violence around you and people are not respecting your boundaries. Anger is to let you know that your boundaries are being crossed, and it helps you to get out of the situation and to bring you back to safety. How do you work on your anger? What do you look for? Take time to notice in your life what things trigger your anger. Is it a particular person or group of people, certain events? Be mindful of where in your body you start to feel your anger. Is it in your heart, your stomach, your fists, your face? Where is the tension? Your jaw, your shoulders, your belly? There are so many different places where it can be. So start noticing your anger triggers before you get too very upset or very angry. See if you can gauge it in the body on a 1 to 10 before you get to the 10 of explosive feelings. See if you can notice your body as you're building up, kind of like a thermometer. And finally, remember to practice your breathing. When you're consciously focusing on breathing, you are not also focusing on getting super upset. Again, if you need your anger because there's violence around you, we don't want you to get rid of it. However, for regular day-to-day, when you're thinking about how anger can affect you and those around you, anger isn't attractive. Anger is something that's needed as an emotion to respect your own boundaries. So, remember to breathe. Inhaling through the nose, exhaling through the mouth, inhaling through the nose, exhaling through the mouth. As you inhale, your stomach goes out. As you exhale, your stomach comes in. What this does is it helps you calm down, and then you could get back, drop the cortisol levels, and connect your brain, get back into the moment, call a timeout if necessary, and just do some deep breaths, because that brings you back in tune with your body, back to the present moment. Practicing this technique while calm can help you when you get very upset and triggered to remind you to practice this technique then. If you don't know how to express your anger appropriately, I'm glad that you stayed until the end. Instead of bottling things up and then purging all of that information onto someone when you're upset, I would love for you to use our communication e-guide as a thank you for watching. Scroll to the description below, click on the link, and that might help you assert in a calm tone, yet not in a tone that's overbearing or causes others to be coercively consenting to you. If you like this video, hit like, subscribe, and the bell, comment below. Follow me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube at The Sex Healer. I release new videos Wednesdays at 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. See you then, and thanks for watching.